Hello and welcome to this tutorial on history of pathology. In this video, I will discuss evolution of pathology. So first of all, with the come of every new disease, there are basic questions that everyone is interested in. For example, what is the cause of disease? When we talk about mechanism, what is the pathogenesis and pathophysiology of disease? Then nature of disease, which explain nature of illness, symptoms and functioning. Pathology have been evolved from supernatural belief to the present state of our knowledge of modern pathology. From religious belief to the rational approach. So what is meant by rational approach? A rational decision-making approach is a methodological approach in which data that has been obtained through observation or statistical analysis or modeling is used in making decisions that are long-term. In the past, people believed that disease is an outcome of curse or evil eye of spirit. Greeks had Asclepius and Apollo as principal god of healing. Dhanvantri is a divine physician or the doctor of God. He is believed to be one of the god who gave us Ayurveda, the ancient system of medicines, and hence is gratefully remembered as father of Ayurveda. But then Hippocrates come and dissociate medicine from religion. Instead, he firmly believed in the study of patient symptoms and described methods of diagnosis. Paulus Celsus was the first that described four cardinal signs of inflammation, such as redness, swelling, heat, and pain. Then Claudius Galen postulated humoral theory, later called Galenic theory. This theory suggests that illness resulted from imbalance between four humors, or we can say body fluids, such as blood, lymph, black, bile, and biliary secretions from the liver. Dissection of human body was strictly forbidden at that time, as that would mean hurting the soul. The end of medieval period was marked by a backward step in medicine. They were widespread and devastating epidemic, which reversed the process of rational thinking again to supernatural concepts and divine punishment for sins. The dominant belief during this period was life was due to influence of vital substance under the control of soul, which is known as theory of vitalism. The backwardness of medieval period is followed by Renaissance period, which is known as revival of learning. The Renaissance began from Italy in late 15th century and spread to the whole Europe. During this period, there was a quest of advance in the art and science. Since there was freedom of thought, there was emphasis on philosophical and rational attitude. Dissection of human body on freshly executed criminals was performed by Vesalius. Invention of first microscope by Antony van Leeuwenhoek. Sir Percival Pott, one of the founders of orthopedic, was the first scientist to demonstrate that cancer may be caused by environmental carcinogens. Thomas Edison, who gave an account of chronic adrenocortical insufficiency termed as Edison's disease. Then during the era of technological development and cellular pathology around middle of 19th century, correlation of clinical manifestation of disease with gross pathological finding at autopsy become the major method of study of disease. Sophistication in surgery lead to advancement in pathology. Pathology started developing as diagnostic discipline in later half of 19th century with the evolution of cellular pathology, which was closely linked to technology advancement in machinery manufacturing for cutting thin sections of tissues, improvement in microscope, and development of chemical industry and dye phosphate. Let's discuss well-known scientists. Paul Ehrlich, German physician, conferred Nobel Prize in 1908 for his work in immunology, described Ehrlich test for urobilinogen using Ehrlich aldehyde reagent, staining technique of cells and bacteria, and laid foundation of clinical pathology. The development of exfoliative cytology of early detection of cervical cancer began with George and Papanicolaou. Robert Koch, the German bacteriologist, beside Koch postulate and Koch phenomena, developed techniques of fixation and staining for identification of bacteria, discovered tubercle bacilli in 1882 and cholera vibrio organism in 1883. The strides made further later half of 20th century until recent times in 21st century have made possible to study disease at genetic level and molecular level and provide an evidence-based and objective diagnosis that may enable physicians to institute target therapy. Then the development of structure of DNA of the cell by Watson and Crick in 1953, and identification of the chromosomes and the correct number in human by Taijo and Levan in 1956. After then, the Philadelphia chromosome or Philadelphia translocation, which is a specific genetic abnormality in chromosome 22 of leukemia cancer cell, particularly chronic myeloid leukemia cells. Then fluorescence microscopy, which helped to detect specific defect of chromosomes. The links has been given to you at below. You can read in details. Then recombinant DNA technology developed in 1972 using destruction enzyme to cut and paste bytes of DNA. As you already studied in your other subjects. Then development of polymerase chain reaction for xeroxing of DNA fragments by Carey Mullis in 1983 has revolutionized the diagnostic molecular genetics. And this polymerase chain reaction has been using currently for identification of COVID-19. So you can see how useful this technique is. And there are different components that has been used in polymerase chain reaction. We are not going to see in detail now. Then mammalian cloning started in 1997 by Ian Wilmot. You can take a look of these links in detail if you want to. The era of stem cell research started in 2000 by harvesting these primitive cells isolated from the embryo and maintaining their growth in the laboratory. So the somatic cells can be grown in the laboratory and can be helpful for growing different kind of cells and organs outside the body. The current era of genetic engineering is very important as newborns die because of genetic disease every day. So the question is, should their genes be modified to save them? Mosquitoes might kill 500,000 of people in coming years. What if the scientists tweak the bug to slow the spread of a disease, such as different epidemics and pandemics in current scenario like COVID-19? So there are many questions that have not been answered yet. So thank you so much for today's lectures. So hope to see you again. Thank you so much.